All right. I have to make this video like today, not like a stress moment, because I'm having the I don't know, electricity changing is happening at some point in the neighborhood. They're, who knows, taking the lines down, or I think perhaps turning into the wind power acceptance, and perhaps if that is the acclamation, they have to switch from the wind power to be the receive for all of the houses, and so that might be why they're taking it out for a few hours. But it is such a weirdness, yeah, to have a take out for the few hours that I'm panicked. I'm like, I have to make a video, because I'm onto these molecules and atoms and their replications, and I have to speak of it, and it has to be uploaded before, because who knows what will happen. It maybe never comes back again. So. Yes, in my panic, I have to tell and I have to express, I want to call it atomification, but it's not really the correct, is it? I can't really say atomification, but it is close to the way it goes, I'm talking about this self-replicating molecule. Also, it's quite an interesting topic that I'm indentured into. Yes, and going back to the beginnings, of where this we have this attractant self and this distractant, not distractant, but the gosh, I can't even say it anymore. The dispellent self of the make, and so there is the raindrop that is bringing the organics, and there is a rock, and it is receiving it, and it's like, well, I really really have a magnetic pull, specifically with these elementals, and so those are my attainments, and those keep my rhythm and my feed, and those become my survival, and I become more and more beautiful. And so it is that particular grouping of receive from the raindrop. All right, so there it is, right in the raindrop, and it is a welcome. It is a welcome moment for the mineral to receive it. And also the other parts of the raindrop, the other organics therein that are nothing to do with. That is not a magnetic attraction moment. All right, so it doesn't have the same energy. Oh, I know. We want to say magneticism is the equation to straight up into the law of experience. We want to say it so quick, don't we? Oh my gosh. Yeah, that is a danger. Alright, I'll try to paint a little at the same time. I completely destroyed my painting. I had it all working, and then I overheated it, and the night was too damp, and on the wall, I put it on the wall, and I don't know, just I didn't guess it was enough or something, and so it all frizzled out and started to crack up, and so I had to put the glue on it now. Now I actually went back to old Elmer's glue, and so I'm looking now at the Elmer glue state, knowing that the underneath is where the peeling is actually coming from. So it's like a moment of capture it, and then and try to keep it from peeling up. Yeah, tempura is a little fussy that way. A lot of persons say, don't do it, go straight with the wood. They paint on the wood often. But anyway, yes, I still have this problem. So we're talking about the atomification, and so there is the raindrop on the receive. The raindrop is on the receive and giving. And you can even say, you can go further and say the pull is actually coming in from hey, you're gonna give me those raindrops, aren't you? I need them. You can go that far and say I'm that magnetic in the energy magnification of a charismatic self right there already, that I'm going to be hauling it in, you know, just that's it, that's my particular. That's my particular right there, you know. Yeah, so that can go on also. It is exciting, yeah. Atomification. Oh my gosh. I kind of have to slow down because I want to bring it into the hot self, physical. Here we are, the hot self, physical hand body. You can say to Ansorik if you have to really be that ridiculous and call it something, and to the sexual state, but yes, it is a bit of it. Touching anything, any object, your particular momentia with it, this type of a blend action, you know, how is it going, how slow, how fast, how aggressive, you know, like you see in that video I was making, the over pointes specifically, you see the over pointes of the feet like some little spoiled child. Okay, I know I was doing this, but it is not the point. It is really cold, and I wrecked my legs earlier, so I was kind of trying to act like a little snooter. But yeah, those don't work. You can't do the over pointe pushes on your feet. Yeah, I wrecked them from what? Oh my gosh! Sometimes I get excited and I jump in and make berets or something around, and I'm not warm. And then oh my gosh, that was the wrong thing to do. Don't be making berets before anything else. Oh, it's like a law. Maybe I write this down as a law. Don't make the berets before. but this energy. Yeah, heavy is the legs. I'm if you start out straight that way, I have to stretch always first. The élongés and all of this style. All right. So here's I'm right now. You're seeing energy happen. You're seeing this momentum, energy happen, and it's a hit action. It's a hit action. So we're talking about the replication of the atoms and the molecules right there. And at this moment, I'm making an action, and it is an action that is ferocious, right there, for this paintbrush to hit the paint in this manner. It is absolutely ferocious. And then there is a soft quiet, you know, there's a soft quiet energy, and so we have the difference. You see, the ferocious one, I left a drop on, it was so ferocious, it expelled out and left a drop extra on my painting. And so now I have to go and make up after it, you know, go and clear up the mistake of my ferocities. So in this moment, there is an energy that is already turned into the, what do we call it, the cat in the hat, the spot character. When you have this spot, you know, you, and it just keeps going bigger and bigger and bigger. It's almost that ferocity, but yeah. Oh my gosh, what a stupid. I didn't mean to make that. You want to hear metaphor? I didn't want to make that. But it is similar. It is similar. Oh my goodness. Yeah, and so the energy hit tap moment. And so if we can, because we cannot really see atoms. We cannot see atoms of air. Right? And this is the oxygen and the whatever it is, the exact H2O, all of it is up there swirling around. And the nitrogens, and it's all in there. It's all in there. And that's little combinations with, I think there's even the helium and other things, methane also on the float up there, all around, but it's in my lungs right now also. So when we have all of these things, and we are reactants, we are reactants also. But if we look at ourselves more as a filter of the objects that are surrounding us. So they do not become the aggressive action take, you know, they do not become this, because that moment, that aggressive action take, where does it go? You know what I'm saying? I have now made a group of disagreeable that is just sending out, you know, a disagreeable, a tantrum to hand a tantrum, a moment of just through movement, just through the movement itself. And so those air, I'm talking A-I-R, those air molecules are now in a created uproar because of my doing. Pretty awful, huh? That's a lot of power. That's a lot of power we have. Unbelievable how much power we have. Alright, so calm it down, you know, stop sending out the beasts, you know, calm it down, you know, stop sending out the beasts of negative, the beasts of overwhelm, stop sending them out, you know. Yeah, stop doing that. I don't know, I can't really think now at the moment. It's almost like it becomes a crutch here, and talking and painting at the same time. Maybe it's this direction at, but no, I don't have good set of gig to be standing and painting or anything like that. My gosh. Now, that's another way also, that's not my style. I can't stand and paint. It's like... But yeah, the energy force that we are giving to molecules. And so there we are, we're replicating it out, aren't we? We are sending a groupage of momentia that becomes a distracted stir, a disturbed stirring. And in the disturbed stirring, yeah, danger. Got a lot of persons that are running in their you know, particular life modes and yeah, there is a creation of it. There is a creation aspect that does become a pattern in their life mode, a particular way, and there does eventuate a calm. And so that is the hope. That is the hope throughout the life that it does eventuate into a calm. That is so many years on the build, you know, so many years on the build for so many persons. So many years. It's like, okay, 10 years old, you're 20 years old, you're 30 years old, am I calm yet? I'm 40 years old, you know, how long do we have to wait to be the calm person? And when I say the calm person, I don't mean like, you know, no personality or anything, but not to send out aggressive at everything. And if it's person to your problem, person to your problem. But even I'm talking with objects in the room, everything, how it is touched. It's just an incredible force that we have that we can release at any moment. And it's an incredible power. So we talk of replication. What are we replicating here? You know, what are we replicating? How am I right now in my voice, in my speak? How am I actually changing the molecules of the air that are coming in later to be the clouds? When I'm changing the molecules into the air that are going to be later the clouds, that is a different group of inertia, a different group of elements that will be transported around the planet, that will be rain somewhere, it will be ice or snow. I'm part of this world, you know what I'm saying? I'm part of this world. So yeah, I guess so. I guess I can't really paint right now and do this at the same time. I don't know. Yeah, I'm part of it, so I'll try to calm it down.